Ever heard of a Google lawsuit? Or how about a drive-by lawsuit? We've found thousands of these suits being filed around the country for violations of the Americans with Disabilities Act. Many business owners think they're nothing more than a shakedown. At first glance, this convenience store in Fort Lauderdale, Florida, may appear to be in compliance with the Americans with Disabilities Act. There's a parking space for the disabled and an access ramp to the store. But the Americans with Disabilities Act has thousands of very technical regulations, and this store is in violation.
What we see here are really sort of the typical red flags that attract lawsuits.
So there is a parking space here.
There is a space. It's not the right dimensions. It needs to be a van space. That means this has to be 8 feet. Uh-huh. This has to be 5 feet.
Attorney Nolan Klein says that disabled parking sign is also in the wrong spot, and it doesn't say the words van accessible. That access ramp isn't right either.
Well, what's wrong with it?
Under the law, this is not an access ramp. So this has to be on an accessible route, which is sort of the area that they tried to create here, but this is supposed to be 5 feet long.
Mike Zayed, who's owned the store for 18 years, says no disabled customer had ever complained about the ramp, the sign, or the parking space. But that didn't stop him from having to hire attorney Nolan Klein when he got sued.
So the person who sued you, you don't believe they were actually a customer in
the
store?
No.
You think they just drove by or stopped outside?
That's what I believe. The lawyer, he just driving around.
That's why it's called a drive-by lawsuit, when a lawyer or a disabled person notices violations outside a business and files suit. Mike Zayed doesn't think the person who sued him was a real customer because the man claimed he encountered barriers inside the store that didn't exist.
To me, I feel it's not fair because to me, I feel like that's a stealing. We work hard for our money and these people just driving around in their car. Here you go. This has a violation here.
Do you know other store owners who have been sued?
I have two guys I know in Broward. They get sued twice.
Same lawyer.
So, same lawyer, same guy.
If you think drive-by lawsuits, hatched from the comfort of a car, are a novel way to enforce a law, there's another kind of lawsuit that requires less work. Lawyers call them Google lawsuits.
What's a Google lawsuit?
A Google lawsuit is where the suspicion, at least, is that the property was spotted on Google, Google Earth, Google Maps, whatever the case may be, and you could see certain things from Google. You could see if there's a pool lift or not.
A pool lift is a seat that can help disabled people get in and out of the water. Since 2012, all hotels and motels in America are required to be accessible to the disabled, which in most cases means having a lift permanently attached to the side of their pool. This is what a pool lift looks like from Google Earth. In the comfort of your own home, with a few clicks of a mouse, you can see if a pool near you has one. And if they don't appear to have a pool lift, like many of these hotel pools we looked up, you can file a lawsuit, just like that. Perry Pustum runs the Adobe Hacienda Motel in Hollywood, Florida. He has a pool lift now, but says he didn't know he was required to install one until he got sued in what he suspects was a Google lawsuit.
Did a disabled person actually come here and want to use the pool?
At no point in time we ever had a customer on the property that requested it or that was even in a room that requested it.
It turns out the same man who sued him sued dozens of other motel owners as well, all for pool lift violations.
It was about 60-something lawsuits in 50-something days.
60 lawsuits in 50 days?
60-plus, yes. And less than 57 days.
All from the same attorney?
Same attorney using the same client.
At last count, that attorney has sued nearly 600 businesses in just the last 2 years, many for not having pool lifts. Perry Pustum ended up paying $3,000 to buy a lift that, so far, no one has ever used.